What's up, YouTube? I'm King Shanks, and this is Droid's Finest, and I'm back with Shadowrun Dragonfall, Part 61. Sorry, I'm loading it up in the screen again, because, again, it won't let me load in-game. So, here we go. Waiting for loading. I want to say thank you to Tariq and Jalil for subscribing, and yeah, a bunch of other stuff. But first, I want to get through this. This has been a very boring mission. Because I'm pretty sure, because it's testing me, I'm pretty sure that I'm supposed to not kill anybody. But I don't know. Either way, we'll find out once I'm done. Hopefully I can finish it up within these four episodes that I'm doing right now. I'm going to be doing four right now and four later on tonight. Because I finally have a Saturday off, believe it or not. Like, jeez, wow. Anyways. Also, I'm planning on updating my tablet soon. I know you guys probably already know I plan on getting an Alienware laptop so I can play all sorts of PC games and Steam games. But I'm also planning on upgrading my tablet so I can do other games such as Reporter and Reporter 2. People have been asking me to do it since I did the mental hospital games. People have been asking me to do Reporter. I've played them, but it won't let me record them. So issues. So I plan on updating the tablet. Hopefully when I get a new updated tablet, I'll be able to play it and record it for you guys so you guys can watch. And watch me scream like a little girl. And it's already been a while since I played the first one. The second one just came out. And I haven't played the second one yet. Just the first one. But we'll get there when we get there. I still have a lot of shit that I need to deal with. For instance, like $3,000 of debt towards legal fees and blah blah blah. Anyways, let's get into this. Now, I'm assuming I'm supposed to go into that door. It's been a while since I played. This game, I don't know, so much reading. This trendily designed panel reads, Apartment 303, a slick high-grade keypad has been mounted into the frame. Okay. Scan your key or enter override code. I don't remember the code. Oh, shit. I don't remember the code. Wait, I wrote it down, I think. I don't know. That might be it. It might be. I don't know. Uh-oh. 14, 2, 9, 14, 2, 9. Oh, no, not 7. I meant 1. Okay, so 14... 2, 9, 1. 1? Ah! See, I'm smart. Leave myself little notes. Last time I was playing, I believe I was drinking, so I don't remember too much of anything. But this time it's just a big gulp, so let's go. Okay, I got it. Shut up. Anytime you want to move, you can. That's nice. Uh-huh. Ooh, a painting. Don't know what the painting's for. Oh, okay. Moving the painting aside, you find a large maintenance access panel. Yana steps forward, a slight frown on her face. Okay, this is me. She pulls a multi-tool from her belt and uses it to loosen the bolts that hold the panel in place. Pulling up a schematic on her PDA, she examines the terminal's wiring. Hurry it up, woman. The clock is ticking. God, that guy is such a dick. Don't rush me. It's complicated. Popping the lid on her toolbox, she grabs a pair of wire clippers and soldering gun. And roll of electrical tape. With a look of grim determination on her face, she begins to snip into a massive harness of cables that runs through the unit. Alright, she taps the elf on the knee. Maybe herself? I don't know, whatever. I'm gonna need that thing now. Oh, never mind, it's the weird elf that can't speak properly. Alright. He nods and reaches into, he nods, reaches back to unsling his pack. Placing it on the floor, he opens it and pulls out a large blue canister. It takes all of his strength to wrestle it up from the ground into the space in the access panel that Yana has cleared. There you go, you dumb ox. Do something useful for a change. The elf says nothing. Unburdened by the heavy pack, he stands up straight for the first time. You appreciate how much larger he is than the corporate mage. He stares down at James and his hands bunch into fists. Say nothing. Stay cool, man. We're almost done. James, for the last time, keep your damn mouth shut. Stay cool, man. Stay cool. You have to stay cool in this. I don't know why. I'm pretty sure I explained why. The guy in the coffee shop wanted to test me, and I think the whole point of the test is they wanted me to go in here quietly and get out quietly without any fucking issues or bullshit. All right. The elf understands you. He shows no sign of it. If the elf understands you, he shows no sign of it. He continues to stare James down, and the mage continues to ignore him. Payload in place, Yana goes back to work. It only takes a few minutes for her to screw wire and solder the canister into the harness. She inspects her work, nods, and turns to face you. She stands and brushes her hair out of her eyes. All right, job's done. Just need to do a bit of a cleanup and we can get out of here. That's it. Nice job, Yana. Nice job, Yana. Yeah, thanks. It wasn't that difficult, just a matter of following our employer's instructions. Hey, that's great, but time's a ticking, so let's keep moving. He glances at the jumble of wire and circuitry through the open access panel. To hell with the cleanup, we'll be gone before anyone notices anything anyways. Just a second. What was the canister you put into the terminal? You're sure that whatever you did disarmed the security system? What was the canister? It's probably a bomb, I'm thinking. We're probably gonna blow this place to smitherblooms. Just blow it all to shit. It's gonna be great. She shrugs. Beats me. For all I know, it could be full of pixie dust. They said that I had to wire into the wall at this junction, so I did. I'm not comfortable with how little we know about this run. Our employers don't tell us much, do they? If they say it'll work, then it'll work. They'd have no reason to lie about something like that. I'm pretty sure that it's a bomb, but we'll just deny. We'll just go with the denial. Oh, we're in denial. Okay, well, let's just stay in denial. They say it'll work, it'll work. An astonished chuckle escapes her mouth. No reason to lie. Do you really believe this? The mage cuts her off. The lodge doesn't tell you things that you don't need to know. And you don't ask. Your job is to do what they tell you to. Take the money and keep your mouth shut about it afterwards. It's very simple. The lodge. The mage sighs widen. You don't even know who you're working for, do you? You're leading this team and you don't have a clue. You're right, I don't. Yana cuts in, her eyes wide. Both of you shut up. Somebody's coming. Where are they coming from? Oh, here we go. A tall spray tan man in an expensive suit rounds the corner at a jog and comes bustling into the room. He stops short when he sees your team. His eyes flick from you to the panel, and Yana pried from the wall, and the smile falls from his face. Oh, here we go. Corporate man, what the hell? This is my apartment, I own it. What are you doing in here? We're maintenance, look at the uniforms. Yeah, I see that, but you can't be in here without my consent, and you sure as hell can't go tearing up my walls without giving me advance notice. Well, too bad, I just did. James shoots you an irritated glance. This is a waste of time, and I'm already running late. If You don't take care of this idiot, I will. The elf barks something out at James. The sound is uncharacteristically ugly, all harsh consonants and sibilant hisses. Okay. Let's keep calm, everyone. This is a simple misunderstanding. Just keep your mouth shut, James. I'll talk this out with our friend here. Handle it, James. I won't stop you. This is all just a misunderstanding. It's all just a misunderstanding. Misunderstanding my ass. Your friend just called me an idiot in my own home. He wheels on James, his hands balled into fists. I want to know your employee number, and I want to know it now. The mage raises an eyebrow, smiling. Do you now? I'm a member of the Homeowners Association for this level. You know what that means. I have a lot of pull with the building management. He thrusts an outstretched finger at James. Your days wearing that uniform are number, I promise you that. Calm down, sir. There must be a problem at dispatch. You should have received a work order last week. The hell with this, James Fryam. You're right, James. We're wasting time. Do what you need to do. No. You should have got the letter from dispatch, bitch. I didn't receive a thing from dispatch, or from anyone else for that matter. My wife and I are entertaining guests here in an hour and a half, and our living room is ruined. Well, that's why I said to clean the mess, you dumb bitches. Why didn't they clean it? Ugh. I need to know that you're going to fix this and that you'll clean the place back up and that you'll put new coat of wax on the floors. I need. The hell with that. I don't have time for this. His hands twist into claws. He raises them high and an instant later, they are wreathed with an unnatural purple glow. Say nothing. James, stand down. We do not need to kill this man. No, we do not need to kill this man. Don't kill him. We're not killing anybody. That's the mission, I think. I don't know. They didn't give me enough information for this mission. I have no idea what to do here. The glow intensifies into a scintillating torrent of light. The energy laces and stabs out of James's hooked fingers as if it were alive. The man in the doorway recoils in alarm, and his palm slaps down on a plastic disc that has been clipped to his belt, sorry. Too late, you recognize this object, a panic button. Ah, here we go. Fighting either way. Okay, so that's what happens, I guess. Try to do the right thing. The air fills with a cacophonous wail of screaming alarms. I don't know what cacophonous means, but sure, that happens. Why not? James jerks back and his concentration broken fall. From down the hall, you can distantly hear the sound of heavy footsteps approaching at a run. Meanwhile, the homeowner backpedals, trying to put a wall between himself and James. He's moving too slowly, much too slowly. James, let him go, damn it. Don't let him get away. Everybody stand down. James, let him go! Idiot! The mage's response comes out with a snarl. Bastard tried to bring security down on us. He isn't leaving this route. An incomprehensible screech cuts off the mage's sentence. In your peripheral vision, you catch a flurry of motion. Your elvish companion is moving, making a beeline towards James. Janna is hanging off him, trying to slow him down, but he barely seems to notice. Stop, damn it. We need him alive to complete this run. With a kick, he sends her tumbling to the ground, then turns back towards James. Step between the elf and James. I hate The bastard too, but Yon is right, we need him. Draw your weapon, she's right. Stop this or I'll put you down. Oh, okay. Out of time. But this has so much reading, it's bullshit. Okay. Scrub the mission and attack James. Okay. I'm with you, pal. To hell with the No, I'm not gonna back him up. Step between them. Okay, I'll step between them. The elf comes up short, staring at you. He sweeps his vision from you to John and to James. Then he exhales heavily and splits into a jumble of broken German. Killers, innocent of, will not stand for, not Slav, slave. I know it's slave. I just said Slav because slave is an ugly word. Anyways, all lodgemen, bastards, I kill all. Okay. Okay, so I guess my next episode I'm going to be in a fight. Cool. Alright. Wasn't expecting... Oh, shit. Well, that kind of hurt. Oh, I can't control them? Oh, no, I have to kill... I have to kill the foreign elf. He's my enemy? What? Yeah, I have to kill the foreign elf. Alright, I'll do that. But I have to do that in the next episode. So, let me save up real quick. And then I'll kill my partner in crime, I guess. Come on, man. I press save. Fucking A. Yeah, take your fucking 45 minutes to fucking load the rest of the shit. Ugh. Ugh. Maybe I should have killed James, but I don't know. James is kind of a douche. Whatever. I'm gonna kill a foreign elf, I guess. That bastard. How dare him be foreign around me. Alright, so I'll be back with the next episode. Stay tuned and I'll see you soon. Peace!